Hola. Buenos días. Sí, señor. Okay. Gracias, gracias. Oh, hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. So, alam niyo ba guys kung bakit ako nagsasalita ng Spanish? Because today you have a very interesting video to be reacting. So this guy is actually speaking 18 languages, a Filipino guy, 18 years old. So, bago natin umpisahan, please don't forget to subscribe on my YouTube channel and also the notification bell para lagi kayong updated. Okay guys, without further ado, let's get started.
I'm Marlon, and I'm 18, and today I'm going to speak in 18 languages.
So imagine, he's speaking 18 languages at the age of 18 years old also.
Kilala
Tagalog.
muna po sa inyong lahat. Ako po si Marlon Ramos, 18 taong kulang na. At purong Pilipina po ako. At ipinanganak ako dito sa Pilipinas. At dahil dito ako ipinanganak sa Pilipinas, natural lamang na nagsasalita na ako ng Tagalog. Ang wikang Tagalog ay ang ginagamit sa pang-araw-araw kong buhay. At ang pag-aaral ng iba't ibang lingwahe ay aking naging paboritong gawain. At kung paano ko sila natutunan lahat ay aking tatalakayin ngayon.
So ang tanong ko, my first question is, saan siya? Anong province ni Marlon Ramos? So kung alam niyo kayo, please comment down below kung taga saan talaga si Marlon Ramos.
At the age of 6, I was taught the English language. It is the second language of the Philippines, and so we were taught English, the English language here in the Philippines in the first grade and up to college, I think. So that is why I think English is a language that I'm most comfortable speaking with because, you know, I've studied a lot of years. I'm fluent in it and I could speak with any English speaker in the world.
So, during our high school days or even elementary and college, we actually do speak Tagalog and English. So, yun yung pinaka main language namin or na ginagamit during our school days or pag nasa room kami, yun yung ginagamit namin. So, sometimes nga mayroon pa kami ano, may rules pa sa classroom na kailangan mag-speak ka ng Tagalog at English para at least maano ka ma masanay ka to speak English and Tagalog po. So, and also para hindi natin makalimutan yung sariling wika natin.
I think learning languages wasn't in my mind then. It's like it's the last thing I could do, but at the age of 12 I knew I wasn't contented with only two languages.
So sabi niya he was already contented with two languages also, so let's see.
Empecé a aprender idiomas extranjeros cuando tenía 12 años y el español fui el primero. Pienso que la razón por qué decidí de aprenderlo era.
So nag-start siya learning Spanish at the age of 12 years old. So that's good. That's a really amazing job.
Cuando miré una película de la biografía de nuestro héroe nacional, José Rizal, la película estaba en Filipino y español.
So nag-start pala siyang mag-learn ng Spanish nung nanood siya ng pelikula ni Jose Rizal and also nagbabasa siya ng bibliography ni Jose Rizal. So, you know, Jose Rizal is a Spanish-blooded.
Español y en ese momento me dije que me gusta el sonido de la lengua española, pues voy a aprender ese idioma. Al comienzo tenía dificultad en la gramática porque, a diferencia de Tagalog, el español tiene muchos verbos tiempos que no entendía, pero seguía con determinación de aprender ese idioma. No tenía un libro ni una maestra, para enseñarme, sino tenía solo un cuaderno y el internet. Pero el vocabulario es muy fácil para mí porque los españoles, los castellanos, colonizaron nuestro país por 3 siglos. Ahora la lengua filipina tiene muchas palabras similares con el español.
So, yung sinasabi niya, yung Spanish language namin, oh, actually, I know how to speak a little Spanish because I was born in Zamboanga City and our language there was actually broken Spanish. So, there is the similarities and to Spanish language also. And also, some Tagalog, there is similarities also Tagalog language to Spanish. May ano pa pagka-similarities. There are some words na ginagamit natin na Tagalog and then to Spanish, I think so. Okay, the next one is Italian.
Quando ho finito lo spagnolo, mi ho detto che voglio imparare più lingue. Allora ho cercato attraverso dell'internet che sono le più facili da imparare. Allora ho imparato l'italiano. La grammatica italiana è molto similare con lo spagnolo perché sono in stessa famiglia di lingue. Sempre parlo con i miei amici per aiutarmi a praticarlo.
So, yung sinasabi niya, grammatically, may pagka-similar yung Spanish sa Italiano.
Ci sono volte quando i miei amici mi dicono che io vado pazzo perché parlo in molte lingue. Anche io ho avuto un amico italiano da Napoli che ho incontrato per Facebook. Mi aiuta sempre con il mio.
He sounded actually Italiano. Pag hindi natin siya nakikita, pwede natin sabihin, oh, this guy is Italian. Ang galing niya, ang galing.
Italiano, sempre corregge gli errori grammaticali che ho fatto.
Next one is French.
Alors, j'ai appris une autre langue, et c'est français. La raison que je l'ai appris est parce que j'aime la France. Je veux aller au Paris avec ma petite amie. Le ramen français, c'est facile parce qu'il est très similaire avec l'italien et l'espagnol. Mais le plus difficile pour moi est la prononciation. Je serai présent, il est terrible. Alors, je
Parang sinasabi niya na mahirap talaga daw ang ano yung language ng French, no?
pratique toujours ma bouche pour ma prononciation s'améliorer. J'écoute toujours des chansons de Kenji Girac et je les aime.
And the next one is Portuguese. Itong Portuguese medyo may pagka-Spanish din to eh.
Agora eu vou falar português. Uma vez quando eu estava assistindo vídeos no YouTube, eu encontrei um music video. E a canção estava em português e fiquei surpreso que posso entender as letras. O português é muito fácil de aprender, é realmente irmã língua do espanhol. E agora eu posso falar com brasileiro e portugueses em mensagens somente, mas eu não posso falar pessoalmente porque não há muitos portugueses aqui nas Filipinas.
So, may naiintindihan kayo, di ba? Wala. So, mahirap din yung Portuguese, no?
Jetzt will ich Deutsch sprechen. Mein Kopf explodierte, als ich Deutsch studierte. Es ist sehr schwer, um zu lernen. Aber ich sagte meinem Geist, dass ich Deutsch lernen kann, wenn ich will, so ich die deutsche Grammatik lernte. Und dann lernte ich, dass keine Sprache ist schwer, wenn man resolut und begeistert von einer Fremdsprache gut zu lernen ist. Jetzt kann ich Deutsch.
So, ayan, yung language na yan, medyo ang hirap-hirap talaga niyan. So, sa kanya parang
Sprechen.
madali
Ich habe
lang.
immer gesprochen mit den deutschen Sprachen.
So, the next one is Dutch from Netherlands. I'm sorry if I pronounce it incorrect. Dutch. Okay, from Netherlands. So they are using the language that's din pala yung sa Netherlands.
Ik meen het in Nederlandse proberen, omdat het gemakkelijk is en vergelijkbaar met het Duits en Engels. Dus ik probeerde het en ik vond het zo leuk. Ik gebruik Duolingo om het te leren en expel en keer per week. En nu kan ik spreken met Nederlandse folk, maar niet erg vloeiend.
So wala talaga tayong naiintindihan, at least ito ang galing niya pa rin sa accent, no? Nakukuha niya pa rin. And the next one is Afrikaans.
Now Afrikaans. Dis my lifeling taal dat ek geleer het. Ek het gedink dat dit 'n moeilike taal te leer was. Maar toe ek dit leer begin het, dit is so maklik. Die grammatika is maklik te verstaan. Die woorde is van Engels en van Duits en van Nederlands. Ek dink dat dit die maklikste taal in die wêreld is. Ek luister altyd na Afrikaanse musiek, soos die David Waterfalls.
Napapansin ko parang may halong English yung Afrikaans, no?
En Brendan Papers music. Saan ka uling van Esperanto?
So the next one will be Esperanto language. Esperanto language is from Poland.
Oni diras ke ĝi estas la plej facila lingvo en la mondo, kaj mi opinias tro. Se vi ne scias Esperanto, ĝi estas inventita lingvo de Dr. Zamenhof. Li faris tiun lingvon por universala lingvo, porque homoj povas lerni ĝin facile kaj parli ĝin. Kvankom ĝi ne estas natura lingvo, multaj homoj ankaŭ.
So, ang galing-galing niya, guys, no? So, salute talaga ako kay Marlon. Ang galing niya, he pronounced it very good.
Para lernas din.
Speechless.
Do, se vi volas lerni tre facila lingvon, vi povas provi Esperanto. Ini saya belajar bahasa Indonesia karena itu adalah tetangga dari Tagalog. Banyak kata dalam bahasa.
Clueless tayo kung anong sinasabi niya. Next we have Indonesia.
Sa Indonesia yang mirip dengan Tagalog karena mereka dalam keluarga yang sama bahasa. Banyak orang dari Indonesia membantu saya untuk meningkatkan saya bahasa Indonesia. Mereka mengajar saya beberapa bahasa gaul, kata-kata, dan kadang-kadang saya mengajarkan mereka Tagalog terlalu. Ada juga banyak orang di Filipina yang sedang belajar bahasa Indonesia juga. Jadi kadang-kadang saya berbicara dengan mereka.
So, ang ano naman, Indonesia parang may ano no, parang may mix ng konting Tagalog. So, mahirap din no, pero paano niya kaya nalalaman yung mga accent that he was able to pronounce or say it correctly? And then he was like sounded the same accent as he was using.
Jag kan tala i svenska men bara lite. Jag tycker om svenska efter.
So the next one is Swedish. So this one I have no idea.
Som det låter vackert och sexy. Jag upptäckte detta språk när jag hörde en låt från Veronica Maggio. Sången heter Hute Norr. Svenska är det enda skandinaviska språket som jag vet. Jag hoppas att jag kan lära mig dansk eller norska en dag. Выйти, меня зовут Марлон, и я говорю по-русски, но я должен сказать, что я говорю зло. Я плохо говорю.
So, wala tayong sasabihin kasi wala tayong naintindihan, and then we will proceed to Russian.
По-русски. Извините меня. Я изучал русский язык, потому что когда-нибудь я буду любить ездить в Россию.
Napapansin ko, parang Russian and Dutch or German language, parang meron silang similarities, no? Yung accent parang konti.
Я думаю, что Россия прекрасная страна.
So, parang may narinig akong budol.
No, numele meu este Marlon. Vorbesc puțin român.
Okay, the next one will be Romanian.
20 klimbare muna anul trecut, dar acum nu mai vorbesc limba română. Am uitat multe cuvinte. Vreau să învăț din limba română.
So, yung first line niya, parang he was introducing himself, and then the next one is parang iba yung accent nila, the way they spoke Romanian. Parang parang may intonation or parang may pitch na medyo paganyano.
안녕하세요. 제 이름은 말론입니다. 한국어를 배우는
So, I have no idea kung ganun talaga magsalita ang mga Romanian. Medyo may pagka, ano yung, may intonation sila. Yung parang umaariba yung pitch nga. Okay, the next one will be Korean.
사람들이 많은 있어요. 그리고 나도 한국어를 공부해요. 한국어는 배우기 어렵는데 재밌어요. 외국어 공부하기 어렵다고 외국어를 배우고 싶다면 포기하지 마시.
Yung Korean naman parang andali lang ng accent, no? I mean, yung language nila parang madali lang talaga matutunan. So,
siyo. Ya, dono mamiu ine marlon, ime apot.
Okay, the next one will be the Greek. Ito, medyo pahirap na ng pahirap to.
Filipinas. Τώρα μαθαίνω ελληνικά και κινέζικα. Η ελληνική είναι μια όμορφη γλώσσα. Λατρεύω το ελληνικό αλφαβήτο. Ωραίο μάλλον.
Correct me guys if I'm wrong. Ang Greek tsaka Swedish parang may similarities. No, parang yung accent, parang same lang din yung ano, intonation or yung tone ng the way they spoke. Okay, yung susunod naman natin is Chinese.
我今天我是我是巴特，是巴西。我来自菲律宾，我是中文和福建，我有两本中国书。菲律宾很多中国人。
Alam niyo guys, sa Pilipinas naman, no, maraming Chinese sa Pilipinas, but I have never learned any words. Maybe yung sikat lang na Kung Hee Fat Choy, yun lang parang yung familiar sa akin. So the rest na sinasabi niya, I have no idea kung anong sinasabi niya. I have no idea kung anong ibig sabihin nun. Let's proceed! Okay, the last one is Ibanag language. I don't know, from Philippines. Maybe I think it's a native language somewhere in the provinces in the Philippines. So let's see.
Ang agaw ni kamong amin, magergot nalabita Ibanag. Egalaman ang 100,000 nga tolay sa ngawot nga amu magergot Ibanag. Kaya usak yaw nga lingwahe para ni kamu nga viewers amuno yaw i nakasta nga lingwahe tajami itat.
Yung lingwahe na Ibanag parang nasa ibang country din, no? Yung accent niya parang hindi ano, parang hindi Filipino accent. I mean, parang ano, nasa
together
somewhere.
So thanks for watching. I hope I have said the right words, and if I have made mistakes.
So ayun na nga guys, no, ang galing niya mag ano, ang galing niya sa bibigyan ko siya ng total impact. Total impact. Bibigyan ko siya ng point na siguro ano, 95% kasi hindi ko inaintindihan yung iba. Sorry to say to give you the 95%. So total is doing a great job.
I'm sorry, I'm not really fluent in all of them. So it's just a practice. So thank you very much.
So, yun na nga guys, no? Ang galing niya, pero yung last na message niya is he was asking for an apology kung if he did not pronounce it properly and or he did not say it properly or correctly. So, at least, no guys, he's trying to speak 18 or different languages that he actually known, and he's doing a great job actually. This guy is such a clever. Yung determination niya para matuto siya ng iba-ibang lingwahe is he's actually pushing through it. So, and then he has this, no, he was using his ways na matuto talaga. So, yung sinasabi niya is your determination, if you're willing to learn something, you need to find ways para matuto ka talaga. So, he's actually doing a great job. There you go guys, natapos na rin natin yung reaction video. Sana may natutunan kayo dahil si Marlon Ramos, ang galing-galing niya. He was such a clever. He's doing a great job. Ang galing niya sa accent. O sana may naintindihan kayo kasi ako meron konti dun sa Spanish lang. But anyways, if you want to learn to speak any languages talaga, we have a bunch of resources o pwede nating pagkunan kung gusto natin matuto talaga ng iba-ibang lingwahe. So, kung determinado ka, sabi niya nga, if you are determined to learn languages as much as you can, so meron naman tayo, kagaya ngayon, we are in a technology na mas mabilis. So, nasa sa inyo na yan guys. So, ang pakikipagkaibigan or natin is not nakadepende kung paano tayo magsalita or marunong tayo magsalita ng ganitong language, Spanish, Chinese, Swedish, or nasa atin na rin yan guys. So the most important is naka-communicate tayo ng maayos. We can use some basic words na pwede nating gamitin to communicate with other nationalities, with other people. So hindi naman hindrance yung language para makikipagkaibigan ka sa isang tao. So, yun nga guys, maraming salamat guys. Sana'y nagustuhan nyo ang reaction video na ko. At sa susunod guys, iba na naman ang gagawin kong reaction. Sa mga hindi pa nakasubscribe sa aking YouTube channel, please don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and also the notification bell para lagi kayong updated. Ayan guys, maraming salamat sa inyo guys. See you again.